My name is Wintley Phipps. I was unconscious when they gave it to me. And at the age of 14 years old, I woke up one morning talking like this. It really messed up my father. If you can imagine your 14-year-old going, "Hey, Dad, how you doing this morning?" Not long ago, I ran into James Earl Jones, and I couldn't resist. I walked up to him and I said, "This is CNN." And he said, "How long have you had that?" My resume is really weird, very eclectic. You'll see on the same page, Billy Graham Crusades and Saturday Night Live. You'll see Robert Shuler's Our Power, and you'll see Soul Train. Now, I know most of y'all have no idea what Soul Train is. Oh, I guess I got some boomers out here. But a man called me one day and he said, "Sir, I heard you sing this song about giving your life to God. I sing inspirational music." He said, "I want you to sing that song on Soul Train." And I said to myself, how is this man going to get me on Soul Train? Because that's all I've done is inspirational music. I learned that you don't have to compromise to be recognized. I've learned that. And so he called up the host, Don Cornelius, and said, "I want you to put this young man on Soul Train." Don Cornelius said, "I'm sorry, I can't put anything religious on Soul Train." And the gentleman said, "Look, Don, all you got is young people dressed funny and, you know, bumping into each other. And what this young man is trying to say in his music, those are the very young people who need to hear it." And Don Cornelius said, "I'm sorry, sir, I can't put anything religious on Soul Train." Then the man said, "Listen, Don, my name is George Johnson of Johnson Products Company, you know, Ultra Sheen, Afro Sheen, and my company's been backing your show for the last 8 years. Next thing I knew, I was the first gospel artist on Soul Train." And it has been a remarkable ride only here in America. I was born in Trinidad in the Caribbean, and at the age of 10, my family moved to Montreal, Canada, where I grew up. Ah, some Canucks out here. And to be a part of my new family and my new country, I joined a hockey team. And they made me goalie because I couldn't skate far. For those of you who didn't get that, that's the equivalent of Jamaican bobsled, you know what I mean? And I was actually born to a very difficult family situation, and I used to get away from my parents' troubles. I had a little red tricycle, and I'd go in the backyard of my house and turn the tricycle on its side and use one of the backside wheels as a steering wheel. And I would sit there for hours, and I would dream. And I would dream that I was flying and driving to far away places in the world and meeting important people when I was 4 and 5 and 6 years old. When we moved to Montreal, I'll never forget, my father used to take us to the airport to say goodbye to people who were going back. You remember when going to the airport was a big thing? You pack a lunch. My father took us to the airport to say goodbye to people, and before leaving the airport, I'd look around to see if anybody was looking. I would grab a handful of the luggage tags and stuff them in my pocket. And I'd go home and close the door and get a pencil and print my name, Wintley Phipps, flight 393 London, flight 676 Paris. And growing up in all this confusion, all my life, however, I have had heroes who have mentored me. Some of them I've never met. Sir Winston Churchill was the hero who mentored me. I'll never forget, in 1995, I took a trip to his grave site beside a little church in Oxford in England. And early, it was VE Day, 50 years after the fall of the German Reich. And I'll never forget, I was by this grave site and there were floral tributes that had been left earlier that morning before I got there by freedom fighters from Greece and France and Norway, who 50 years later could not forget what Sir Winston Churchill meant to the world in a critical hour of Earth's history. But there was one tribute that I did not disturb, but I read it. It was obviously written by an American. It was on a single sheet of paper, handwritten, an American flag in the corner. And this American was thanking Sir Winston Churchill for what he meant to the world. And in it, he closed with words of John F. Kennedy about Sir Winston Churchill, who once said of Churchill, "He commissioned the English language and sent it off to war." And that's what you do. Commission language and send it off to war. Some of the heroes I've never met. George Washington Carver did a documentary on his life. You know who he is? He invented peanut butter. Probably your hero too. But he said one day, he said he asked God to show him the mysteries of creation. And God told him, "You can't handle the mysteries of creation. Ask for something you can handle." He said, then he asked God, "Show me the mysteries of the peanut." Another one of my heroes was Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. I remember sitting watching a film, Montgomery to Memphis, black and white, and hear this speech, "I have a dream," and heard pathos like I'd never heard it before. And I resolved in my heart, I wanted to be like that kind of man who was willing to even die for what he believed. I've had heroes that I've never met. Hey, I never met him, but Luther Vandross was one of my heroes. Oh my goodness. That man could paint 1,000 colors in one song. Can I tell you something about singers that you may never know? Every singer in every song makes mistakes. But the great ones know how to make a stumble look like a pirouette. The great ones dazzle you with their recovery. And then I've had heroes that I've met and I've worked with that it's been my joy to know. I was the last one to sing Amazing Grace for Mother Teresa before she died. I was in the crowd that welcomed Nelson Mandela when he came out of prison. I was on an Eastern Airlines flight years ago. Los Angeles to Atlanta, big L-1011. Always used to fly like that, you know. And I saw this lady and flight attendant. She looked a little discouraged. So I went back to my seat and I got a cassette of my first album. You remember cassettes? And I said to her, "You know, I just feel impressed to give this to you. The kind of music I sing is inspirational music." She said, "Thank you so much." She said, "I travel with a cassette player." And she said, "Thank you. I've been having a rough time and this will be really a blessing." 3 days later, she's working another flight and runs into a man who's on the flight by the name of Cliff Barrows, who directed all the choirs and the music for the Billy Graham Crusades for about 50 years. She says, Mr. Barrows, it's such an honor to have you on my flight. She said, but can I ask you something? Have you ever heard of a young man by the name of Wintley Phipps? He said, no, I've never heard of him. She says, hold on a minute. She went to her purse and got that cassette and handed it to him, saying, this has been a blessing to me, but I want you to have it. 3 weeks later, I got a call from Cliff Barrows saying, we want you to become one of the soloists with the Billy Graham Crusades. And for 25 years, it has been my honor to travel all over this country and some other parts of the world with a great hero of mine. And so some of the heroes I've met, and some I haven't. One of the things I must tell you about those heroes, though, they inspired me to dream. They inspired me to dream. But my greatest heroes are names you may never know. Elaine, that was my mother's name. When she saw that I had this gift and drive, she wanted to channel it right. So she bought me some Temptations cassettes. And I became the Temptations all by myself. I can do it. I can turn a gray sky blue, or I can make it rain, you know, whatever I want to do. Oh, I can do it. And I do all the voices, you know. Oh, I forgot to tell you about two other heroes that I met. Growing up in the 60s. Okay. Growing up in the 60s, I confess, I wanted to be another Sly Stone. But then I met Sly, and he was Stone, and I said, no, something's wrong with this picture. My hero is incoherent. And then I would get a microphone, and I'd practice singing like my new musical hero. I'd walk around the house singing, it's not unusual to be loved by anyone. Oh, I want to be Tom Jones so bad. But I met Tom Jones. I was 15 years old. Can I tell you something about Canada that I love about Canada? Canada's always kind of 10 years behind America in its innocence. You could get away with stuff 10 years longer in Canada than you can in America. Well, let me explain it this way. I had a job one time, a summer job, selling ladies' dresses in Canada door to door. I had a rack of dresses, and I'd knock on the door, and they'd open the door and let me in and look at all the different styles and stuff, and if they found a size they wanted, they would go in the back room while I was in the house, try it on, and if they liked it, pay me for it right there. Now, you know you couldn't do that in America. That's why I love Canada. But some of the heroes, I've been blessed, and one of them was my mother. She was an incredible human being. I want you to meet perhaps one of the greatest heroes of my life. She happens to be here today. It's my wife of 34 years, Linda. Will you mind saying hello to Linda? Linda, will you stand? I chased her till she caught me. And I told her, if she ever leaves me, I'm going with her. But my wife is an incredible human being. I'll tell you a little bit about her later. But she is, you know, it's nice to be married for 34 years and look 34. And she's the only woman I know that has been kissed by the man who loves her on every continent of the world. except Antarctica. She has been kissed in China, in Australia, in Africa, in South America, in Europe. Hey, isn't that great? That's my wife. Thank God for the heroes who inspire us to dream and invest in us.
Good morning, Wealth Builders Worldwide. Welcome to the Freedom Friday Power Call. Please state your name and where you're calling from in the chat box. If you're on GoVox, please state your name and where you're calling from. Normally we do the shout out, but we don't have that capability on here at this time. But listen, we want to see where you're calling, where you're chiming in from. Florida, New Jersey. Got Georgia in the house, North Carolina, South Africa, yes, awesome. We're all over the place. New York, my family. Of course, you got my family in Georgia too. Come on now. Chicago, Kentucky, Virginia, amazing. All right, well, let's continue and let's get this call started. And again, good morning. Welcome to the Freedom Friday Power Call. I am so excited about this call today, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for all of our leaders that are with us today, all of our guests that are with us today. And ladies and gentlemen, if you're one of our guests that's here with us today, we have a special overview for you and why we get together every day. And I'm going to reset my screen here. Hang on. All right, so we're going to show you why we get together every day. So sit back and take a listen, and let's go. And today, let me find my screen. And today, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take this call over to from Memphis, Tennessee, the one and the only Mrs. Yolanda Parkinson. Over to you, Yolanda.
Great and glorious day. This is Yolanda Parkinson calling out of Memphis, Tennessee, and this is your Carrot Bars overview. Carrot Bars International, an e-commerce company, has made available a simple wealth building system for everyone on the planet who is 18 years of age and older with three optional ways to participate. Option one, save gold. We all start here. We complete the free registration for our gold savings account and start acquiring Karat Bars Gold in small increments. Karat Bars International has made it easy by making available a feature called Auto Exchange. At Wealth Builders Worldwide, we call that pay yourself first. You set up your account to automatically exchange your paper currency for Karat Bars Gold weekly, bi-weekly, or monthly. You simply set it, forget it, and then go back and increase it. Activating this feature allows you to automatically pay yourself first with physical gold. No fees of any kind. The account is completely free and takes less than 5 minutes to register. Every time you acquire Karat Bars Gold, you are building your family's wealth. Option two, save and earn. As an independent affiliate, when you save gold for yourself and share with others how to do the same, you position yourself to be compensated monthly through our Unilevel System Compensation Plan. You are virtually in business for yourself in over 140 plus countries worldwide. Option three, maximize your earning potential. You may choose one of several business packages which position you to generate cash flow monthly and weekly through our dual compensation plan. These packages are income producing assets. Some people have asked, why Karat Bars? A Karat Bars Gold Savings Account gives you protection against future financial crisis and rapid inflation. It protects your hard-earned paper currency with physical gold. Karat Bars International has made the only system in the world where you can get free gold. Gold is a store of wealth and value and is an appreciating asset. There are three major benefits of a Karat Bars Gold Savings Account. Number one, you can now start saving physical gold in small increments. Two, Karat Bars International puts you in position to build a global business from the comfort of your own home. And number three, there are significant tax advantages to owning a home-based business. Wealth Builders Worldwide mission, to provide individuals worldwide with the tools required to enhance their lives, achieve their dreams, and build massive wealth. We are salespeople. We are a sales team. We do not sell products, goods, or services. We sell people on the infinite possibilities of their lives and the power of their dreams. We sell people on never giving up. We believe that this is a noble cause. Now, if you are a guest on the line today, get back with the person who invited you to the call and let them know you are ready to open your free Karat Bars Gold Savings Account right now. Back to you. Boss it up.
Yes, yes, yes. Thank you so much, Mrs. Yolanda Parkinson. That was an amazing, did I say amazing? That was an amazing overview. And Yolanda, this is for you. Leader, please continue to send us your overviews. We need more. Come on now. Instructions are on mywbw.net, and you'll see the second tab that says Karat Bars Overview. And all we ask that you do is record it and, you know, less than 4 minutes, please, and send that over, those instructions on the bottom, where to send it to, and what we ask of you to do as you do those overviews. So again, we love hearing these overviews. Keep sending them in. We are excited. So good morning, everyone. What an amazing day. What an amazing pre-call. You know, we've been hearing so much and being educated so much this week. I had to take us back to dreaming again today. And that's one thing I love about Wintley Phipps, is that his whole testimony, if you listen carefully from the beginning, when he was on that tricycle, pretending he was flying around the world, and he dreamed at such a young age. And so, ladies and gentlemen, many of us had dreams even at a young age, and we've forgotten some of those dreams. So today, I'm honored that we have heroes on this call that inspire us to dream again. And that's one thing I appreciate about the leadership that we have here, not only in Carebirth, because Harold Seitz, he's inspiring us to dream again. And then our senior partner, Mr. Ty Beth and Valerie Beth and Mr. and Mrs. Dalco and many of the other leaders on this call inspire us to continue to dream or to dream again. So ladies and gentlemen, that was a powerful testimony of Wentley Phipps. And as you heard, he did get to travel around the world and he got to kiss his wife on every continent except Antarctica. So I hope that was inspiring for you guys today. Get back to dreaming. If you've been sidetracked with all the craziness that's been going on around us, you shouldn't be, because we're wealth builders. We have a tool in our hand to help people and to help change lives. So that's all I have to say. That inspired and touched me today, that pre-call, and just to keep dreaming. And like I said the other day, don't be weary dreaming big. You will see your freedom in due season. So what I want to do now is bring over to, on this call right now, my sponsor, my brother, and one of my heroes, who is Mr. Free 103, Mr. Michael Dalco from Atlanta, Georgia. Good morning, Mr. Dalco. How are you?
Good morning, Mr. Bergen. Good morning, Wealth Builders. Oh, fantastic call today. I'm loving it.
And I'm not hearing you, sir.
Can you hear me? Can you guys hear me?
Yes, I hear you great.
Okay. Okay. Mr. Berger, you make me nervous, man. Saying you can't hear me. Okay. Good morning, Wealth Builders. Au, fantastic call already. I love the fact that you took us back to the dream today. You know, I was actually meditating on this morning. I woke up first thing this morning dreaming big. I was actually considering doing amazing things in the midst of what is considered a global health crisis. And I was thinking about different things I want to do for the family and just big dreams, not being limited by what appears to be our current circumstances. You know, I was listening to some financial education by one of my financial mentors, and they were talking about how the government is passing all these different stimulus bills to artificially, you know, fire up the economy. And he was talking about how the political parties are two sides of the same coin. They're literally just injecting free money and giving workers more money and unemployment benefits than they would if they went to work, and it's discouraging people from working. They were just going back and forth with all these political debates. And it just encouraged me that we're on the right track. Like, we don't have to get involved in all of that blatant stupidity, where we can just teach people to be self-sufficient, build a business of their own, and live outside of the global economy, where we can dream big and we're not limited by what's going on in the world. Man, Mr. Ty Best sent a bunch of us a video today. Don't get jealous if you didn't get the video. Just know your time is coming. But it was a dream video where this guy started a company to just show lifestyle, you know? And it started as a blog, and this dude turned this thing into a $1 million enterprise. He dropped out of college because he had a bigger vision for his life. And literally, this magazine, this internet magazine, is as big, it's bigger than Forbes. And I had never heard of it. Guys, let's just dream really, really big. Don't limit yourself by things that might be around you, by what you think your background says you should be able to accomplish. You've got a vehicle in your hand that's getting faster. They're fueling up the jet fuel right now as we speak. Dream bigger, man. Look, I believe that our dreams have the power. Watch this. This is a global energetic conversation right here. I believe our dreams have the power to empower Dr. Seitz. Now, maybe somebody can even make that better as we continue the conversation, but I think that as we dream bigger, because we're connected to the vision of Dr. Seitz, it gives him even more power. One of the things he said to me in person is when I was saying, thank you, Dr. Seitz, you've changed me and my family's lives forever. And he said in his broken English, this gives me the power. When people say things like that, this is what gives me the power. Mr. Best told me yesterday. He said, you've got to read Harold Sides' book to get firmly rooted in what we're doing in this business. You know, you can get frustrated and say, what are they doing? This is not working and that's not working. And man, they need to speed up or this or they, what are they doing? And not this and they're not that. And Mr. Best says, when you read Harold Sides' book and his humble beginnings and his love for networking, network marketing, you'll lose a lot of your frustrations with the things that don't go according to plan because you'll know that this gentleman is firmly committed to this mission. So back to you, Mr.
Oh, thank you so much, Mr. Dalko. We almost kind of lost you there, but we heard you. We heard what you said. Thank you so much. And thank you, Mr. Dalko. I'm going to say it. I appreciate you. Thank you for being my hero. Thank you for telling me about Carrot Barter. I cannot imagine. I don't even want to think about where I would be if I wasn't here today. Whew, man. So what I want to do now is I want to hand this call over to the Dreammaker family. And Mr. Beth and Mrs. Beth from Newport News, Virginia, good morning and over to you.
Good morning. Good morning, Mr. Berger. Team Best, what do we say? Hi-ho. Good morning. I'm going to turn this call over to Ms. Valerie Best. Let her say something to you real quick.
Oh, good morning. Good morning. Good morning, Mr. Berger. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
Anyway, I'm in good spirits. I know we're out here. We're all out here in good spirits because I love the message that the pre-call was excellent. And I love the message that Mr. Delco said, you know, that, you know, Harold Sides has got, he's got it together and he's got us all on the right track. That's all I got to say. I'm just excited. Back to you, Ty.
Hey, thank you. Look, I had one thing I was going to say, and of course, Mr. Dalko sent me down another road. So, because all I really was going to say this morning was freedom. And that's what it's all about. After hearing the pre-call, that's really all I wanted to say. But I said, well, I got to add a couple more points because freedom is what it's all about. But what an incredible pre-call. It lit the dream up. That's excellent. He said so many things that just sort of twisted me in certain ways I wanted to comment on. But I would just encourage you to hit the call again because it talked about having dreams at 4 and 5 years old of traveling and seeing the world. See, you don't have to know how your dream is going to come about, but you must have the dream. The second thing, the video I sent out this morning to probably 500 plus people or more, every time I send a video out, folks, I ask you to share it with your team because I'd be up all day just texting. But the primary video talked about 15 industries that are going downhill, and I mean going downhill fast because of this worldwide health crisis. And as I'm watching all these industries be just devastated, I mean, overnight, I'm sitting here thinking to myself, oh, to God be the glory. In 1983, somebody talking about a home-based business. And my wife and I elected in 1983 to make this our life's mission, to be free, to be able to work from home, to be able to spend time with each other, not have to commute someplace, not have to go somewhere. And we saw this, and we saw the tax benefits, and we saw the income potential was unlimited, and we saw we could be our own boss in 1983. Now, we didn't understand all of the ramifications, how it would insulate us from the economic things that are happening worldwide in a major. We didn't see all those things. We've experienced all those things because we didn't really feel 2000 or in the early 90s when they had a recession. And we didn't feel it in 2000. And we didn't really feel it in 2008 because Mr. Dalko said we're outside of the box, the economic box in what we do. And folks, that video right there should fire you up to let you know how desperately people need what we have. You don't have to sell anybody's thing today. If you have to sell somebody today on why they should know how to learn how to make money from home, I don't know who you're talking to. You have to sell somebody today on they need to think about being independent because there's no such thing as job security. We're talking about millions of industries, jobs just wiped out in 2 weeks. And so my video, I said, dream big and serve people. And then the last point I want to make, Mr. Dalko said, yes, I encourage you to read Dr. Seitz's book because, folks, about 20 years ago, Van, I was, you know, we've gone through quite a few CEOs in this network marketing journey. And we were talking to a gentleman one time, and he said to us, we've been in this dead time about 12, 13, 14 years. And he said, listen to me. If the owner of the company was never a distributor, if the owner of the company was never an affiliate, if he's never done what we do, they would never get it. They can't pick up a book and get it. They can't read it in a book and get it. They can't understand our mindset. They can't just, you can't just give them what we think, okay? And in every case, if you go and track almost every company that succeeded big time in this industry, every company that had some legs on that went 8, 9, 10, 15 years, you'll find almost every single case, the person that started that company started exactly like you did. Somebody introduced them to the industry. They made a list of family and friends, and they got started. And it led them to ownership. Yes, my wife and I owned three companies, but it led us to ownership. And that's why I understand wholeheartedly many of the sacrifices and many of the problems, things Dr. Harold Sykes has to deal with on a day-to-day basis. And I don't have any desire to be company owner at all. But I'm so excited about Dr. Harold Sykes being the owner because I understand where at 18, 19 years old, he entered into this direct sales industry. And it's his heart, it's his passion, and he understands us and what we're all about. And there is no quit in him. That's important. It's an important message. And Van, I learned after 12 or 13 years in this industry. That's vital what Mr. Dalco said. I would encourage you to get his book, read his book, and then you understand where he's coming from. And you attach your vision to his vision, and you won't worry about what he is doing. You're about what we must do. And what we must do, build our team, go get more people, go get more people, go get more people, go share more people. And wait a minute, not to take advantage of them, but to serve them. As you hear over and over on this call, everybody said, I thank my sponsor for inviting me to the world of Carrot Bars. So forgive them when they don't understand what you're sharing with them, for they do not know what they don't know. God bless Team Best. What do we say?
Hey, Mr. Best, I have one quick question. Now, hopefully not to take you down the rabbit hole, I do want to expedite the call. I do get a lot of calls, and for those of you who do call me, don't stop calling me because I'm making a statement. I just want to bring up some level of clarity and emphasis to what Mr. Best and Ms. Valerie Best have been able to teach me over the last 6.5 years. I don't think that I was unlike most people. And I do mean most. Mr. Best made a post that says our challenge is to turn employee minds into entrepreneur minds. I'm paraphrasing that. But I guess my question to you, Mr. Best, is what do you say to people who by natural recourse concern themselves with the logistics of the company, with any company? I mean, I called PayPal with Ms. Maxine Jones yesterday, and the first thing on their voicemail was, due to the global health concern, response times are super slow. Please bear with us in this difficult time. It's slow everywhere. Everything's harder right now. What do you say to people that have the natural inclination to be concerned about the frustrations of shipments or whatever the challenges are with the company to keep them focused on the main thing? Please, if you could briefly share that with the team.
All I can tell them is what serves me. And, you know, it's an old, and many people have heard this thing is, you know, God, give me the power to control the things that I can control and understand the things that I cannot control. And that's very critical in this business. You know, we don't fix the problems in Carrot Bars. I don't fix shipping. I don't fix the laptops coming out. That's not what I do. But I trust that that's what Dr. Harold Sykes is going to take over and do. And I let Carrot Bars do what Carrot Bars do, and I do what I'm supposed to do, and that is to build the team. And they go, well, how can I build a team with all these things going on? I said, every business has challenges. You got to raise your attitude above the challenges and keep painting the dream and painting the picture. A brand new person don't even know about the challenges. See, so the challenge is only hindering you and your thought process. I go tell a brand new about Carrot Bars, all they know is, hey, wait a minute, let me ask you a question, everybody. Did you get paid today? The answer to that question is, yes, we did. And we've gotten paid every single Friday and the first of every single month for 6 years. A brand new person, that's what they want to know, okay? And that's what you got to raise your attitude above to focus on what is right in the company. What is right is we get paid every Friday. The program's right. The well plan right. The track record is incredible. The credit behind the company is incredible. All those things are right. But there are a couple things that got to be worked on. Okay? And we can do the same thing in life, Mr. Dalko. We can, you know, we marry somebody. We fall in love with somebody. When we first met them, we saw everything. It was perfect. But, oh, man, she was just gorgeous. She was incredible. She was this. He was that. He was all this. He was all that. And after 3, 4, 5 months or 3, 4, 5 years or 10 or 15 years, if we're not careful, all we can see is the flaws. All we can see is, you know, that woman snores, okay? All we can see is that person, he ain't took a shower in 3 days, okay? I'm talking about myself, okay? You know, all we can see is what they don't do right. Hey, they leave the toilet seat up. We focus on all those minute things that the person's been doing for 5 or 10 years. But now they bother us. That's our whole focus. We forgot the fact that, wait a minute, now, you know what? I like talking to this person. Sometimes they get on my nerves, but most of the time they don't, okay? We forget all those things. It's the same way for our carrier boss. They sit and say, wait a minute, I've told you a minute. I know I'm down a rabbit hole. Anyway, back, hey, folks, let me just stop and say this. Focus on what's right, and then go get new people. And then when you're talking to new people, talk about what's right. Don't talk to them and say, look, I'm going to tell you about carrier boss. And there's a few things going on we got to work on. There's going to always be a few things on carrier boss got to work on. I don't care. There's a few things right now Amazon.com's working on. There are a few things Microsoft working on. And we don't even want to talk about the iPhone. And we're on iPhone 11. And why every iPhone I get got to have some kind of glitch in it they're supposed to fix. And before I knew I got to get iPhone 12, they never fixed the glitch to iPhone 11. Man, please, stop the madness. Focus on what's right. And right now, carrier boss is the rightest thing I've ever seen in my 37 years. And right in the midst of this health crisis, okay, and we got a company that has ridden out this crisis, okay, that's doing everything it can do, and we're still operating 24/7 in 146 countries, and you can build that business with an unlimited opportunity from home. You ain't got to go outside unless you go into the grocery store and come back home. And you can actually make money sitting at your house. I'm making this coffee right now. I'm lying in my bed in my pajamas. Okay? And I'm not worried about money. I'm not stressed about money. I'm not worried about the virus. I'm not worried about my family. I'm not worried about my kids. They're right here in the house with me. I'm not worried how they're going to survive because we're all one family here. We said team best. We mean it. Mr. Why you do this to me, man? Look, God bless tonight, folks. We have a real talk. The real talk is at 11 o'clock. That's right, for leaders only. It's the wealth gap. Closing the wealth gap. And anything else that comes up. Mr. Del and I, go Rocks, 11 o'clock tonight. Ms. Best, you want to say something?
We got paid today.
I know we got paid today. Okay. I shared it with
you. Oh, okay. Sorry.
God bless. Team Best, why don't we say it one more time?
Ahoo! And this is for you guys. This is amazing. I love it. And man, I hope you are listening, especially about putting the toilet seat down. That's all I'm going to say. If you're not trained by now, you need to renew your mind quickly. Anyway, so listen, thank you so much, Mr. and Mrs. Beth. We appreciate your wisdom and your feedback. And Mr. Dalko, when you were talking about how we fuel Herald sites, I'm thinking we are the gasoline. Our dreams are the gasoline to fuel him to do more. So that's powerful. Thank you, Mr. Dalko, and Mr. and Mrs. Beth, for all that you guys do. We appreciate you, and Manisha Dalko as well. We love you guys. So what I'm going to do now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to bring on one of our amazing moderators, known as the Golden Voice of Wealth Builders, Mrs. Maxine Jung from Team Empire. Good morning.
Good morning, Mr. Berger and Wealth Builders. And you know what, Mr. Berger? Thank you for sharing Carrier Boss International with me. But what I'd like to do right now is personally and publicly thank Mr. Michael Dalko for his assistance with my PayPal account yesterday You know, Mr. Best says that leadership is inconvenient, and it is. Mr. Dalco was on the phone with me and a member of the PayPal staff yesterday for quite some time, trying to straighten out my account so that I could register for Let's Go Worldwide. I have been trying on my own for several days, but due to the coronavirus, they had limited staff. And you know, at one point I texted him and said, this is like a three-way call, but neither of us are speaking. But the gentleman figured it out. So thank you, Mr. Michael Dalco, for your leadership, sir. You are a leader among leaders. And I am officially registered. So thank you very, very much. Back to you, Mr. Berger.
Thank you so much, and you're welcome, Mrs. Jones. I am so glad that you said yes as well. And Mr. Dalco, this is for you. I know you don't like this, but you know what? I'm going to do it anyway because we love you. Thank you for your sacrifice.
Hey, Mr. Berger, I got to sneak back in. I got to sneak back in and say one more thing. And please, folks, please hear me out. The Dalcos have been behind the scenes working. See, people don't see what's going on behind the scenes, working diligently to put this world Wealth Builders Worldwide live event together. And that's next, it's right here. That's next Saturday from 12 to 4. I'm telling you, folks, if you're not that's negative. Promote this thing to everybody you can. Those who are in, those who think about the blue dots, tell them, say, man, you look, this is exploding because the world needs a legitimate home-based business with a track record, a proven track record behind it. This is not the time to be experimenting, practicing on something new. We got the CEO and founder going to be talking to the entire world next week from 12 to 4. And we got the leadership from all across the world of Carabas going to be on that thing. I'm actually going to shave and cut my hair and all that stuff somehow between now and next Saturday. I'm telling you, folks, you want to be there. You want to share with everybody. You want to get your ticket, and you want to be at that live event. Last night it was simple to call. The business is simple. People are complicated. I think Greg McKay said it. I could be wrong. The business is simple, but people are complicated. Please, let's not let us, the gladiators, complicate it. Let's just do the fundamental things we supposed to do and go find people on the team who want to get in and keep it simple to build wealth and do those simple things. Plug in at 10:45, plug in at 12 o'clock, plug in at 9 o'clock from home, and then be at the live event next Saturday from 12 to 4. And I assure you, folks, for those who get yourself 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, how many people you can get there at that event, your business is going to explode, and you'll never worry about making money outside of your house again. Okay? You'll go back to work, and everything gets back to normal, fantastic, God willing, hope it does, all that stuff. But in the meantime, you can get paid now. And the way to do it is take massive action and take advantage of every single online event that's taking place, every launch party, every presentation, every training session you can. Plug into Facebook and stay in tune with everything that's going on. God bless. Back to you, Mr. Berger.
Whew. Thank you so much, Mr. Best. I'm excited. Again, that's next Saturday. If you haven't gotten your tickets yet, get your tickets at WBWEvents with an S at the end there, .com. WBWEvents.com to get your tickets for next Saturday. I'm excited.
Hey, Mr. Berger, I had to come back in again.
Sure, no problem. Go ahead. No problem.
See, that's why we have the real talk, because real talk, we can go on for 2 hours. I got to say this one last thing. And I believe the tickets are $30. And somebody said, $30? Man, I said, stop. Will you stop? Will you stop? Will you stop? I said, what? That's just negative. People pay $20,000 to sit in class for a whole semester and learn nothing that would truly change their life. And we think that's normal. We'll do that and won't even bat an eye. We'll pay $100,000 for an education because we've been conditioned to do it, and then come out and look for a job. And then somebody will say $30. Man, really, it should be about $300 for the info. You're not paying for the 4 hours. You're not paying to be entertained. You're paying for some life-changing information. If a person is getting carabars and pay attention to what they hear on our training about the tax benefits alone. That alone is enough. Oh, by the way, an event ticket is a tax write-off in itself, too. I mean, come on, folks. We hesitate on two. And wait a minute. And those same people who will complain about $30 to learn something about their finance, their future, their mindset, will drop $100 for two tickets to go see somebody on stage, jump around, dance, and sing, and entertain them. Please, we, Gladiators, we got to elevate our thinking and in order to elevate the thinking of everyone else. Okay? I'm off my soapbox now. Back to you, Mr. Berger.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Mr. Bell. Whew. Okay, where am I at now? Okay. My goodness, I love this. I love it when we get feedback from our leaders. I love it. I appreciate you guys so much because you're always dropping those golden nuggets for us. Life-changing nuggets, may I add. So what we're going to do now, we're going to open up our, we call it the Q&A session. Almost as past *6 than the number one, but nope, not here. If you're calling in, dialing into this platform today, you press *9 to raise your hand. And if you're on the platform, goldrock.info, you see at the bottom, there's an option to raise your hand. So go ahead and do so at this time. And when I call your name, that means your mic is ready to be unmuted, so you have to unmute yourself. Okay, let's go, let's do it. All right, our first leader on the line today, Damowing, you're live.
Good, lost my microphone. Good morning, Mr. Undercover Brownie Berger. This is Damowing in the California desert. I just want to give a shout out to Team Audacity and to my Shiro, who is second only to my mother, Cece, my sister, Mahone. And also, I want to say, this year I'll be 70, but I have heroes and Shiros in Wealth Builders Worldwide that are younger than me, a few that are older than me, different colors, different sizes, different shapes, only in Carat Bars International. Back to you.
Thank you so much. You have a wonderful day. Always great to hear your voice.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, D-Mowie. Happy birthday to you.
My well, happy birthday. It's not today. I said I'll be 70 this year.
Oh, well, there it is. That's, we don't have
but
to
thank you.
See, you already got your thinking for the year.
Yes. Thank you.
Well, Mr. Dalco, thank you for singing. We don't get to hear you singing that, man. Come on now, Mr. Dalco.
That's right.
Hold on. Let's see if I can do this right here. All right. There we go. All right. Next leader, Christopher Chalbe. Come on, my brother. You are live.
Golden morning, Mr. Rodney Berger and all Wealth Builders Worldwide. It's 5 and 5, Christopher Chalbe calling live from Largo, Maryland. Outstanding pre-call, outstanding overview. I want to give a congratulations to one of my old friends from preschool who signed up last month and this morning got his business package and he's currently setting up his auto exchange. So I want to congratulate him and I want to tell everybody that's on this call, we almost there, y'all. Just stay focused. Keep your eyes on the prize one day at a time, one gram at a time, one person at a time. Let's go, y'all. I want out.
Man, I appreciate your consistency, brother. Listen, congratulations. Man, thank you so much. You have an amazing day, brother. Appreciate you. Next leader. 601-896. You're live.
All right. Good morning. Good morning, Mr. Rodney Berger, Glenn Perkins out of Jackson, Mississippi. It's so always so excited to be on the call. First of all, I want to thank my sponsor, Mr. Phenomenal Businessman here in Jackson, Mississippi, Mr. Cammy Kitchens, for inviting me to this beautiful system. Like I say, I want to also recognize represent Team Adachi, by the way. Also, Mr. Cluis Cox, exchanging cash, going down in value cash into gold. Also, want to congratulate Pastor Weathersby, Kenneth Weathersby out in Nashville with his growing team. Welcome, Mr. Felix Duran from St. Thomas, Virgin Islands. Also, and I want to just recognize Mrs. B.J. Jordan here, always helping everyone. Just her favorite slogan is teamwork makes the dream work. Just congratulations and thank her for everything she does to the team. Everyone have a great day. Mr. Berger, keep doing an excellent job. Au.
And I'm telling you, I want to give her congratulations to BJ as well. She's amazing. And Mr. Parkins, we appreciate you as well. You are an amazing leader as well. Thank you so much. You have an amazing day. Mr. Make sure you mute yourself, Mr. Perkins.
Thank you so much.
Yes, sir. Yeah, we're going back and forth there. That's weird. Okay, there we go. Next leader, Wendell Osborne, you are live.
What's going on, Mr. Berger? Can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Loud and clear.
All right. Minister of Farm, guys. I am just jumping in. Mr. Ty Best, I just want to make sure I heard you right. You know I like simple, and I love numbers. Are you flat out just telling us to stay in our own lanes, do the part we're supposed to do? I'm just saying. That go fast yesterday, when is part two? Guys, look, take your crypto, some of it, all of the discretionary, turn it into gold as fast as you can. Tell as many people as you can. I'm out.
Hey, I just want to make sure I heard you right. Did you say that you got a package?
No, I didn't get a package.
Oh, okay. I heard you say pack. So I thought maybe you really,
yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I got my multi-pack. We good over here, everybody.
All right. All right. Well, hey, man, thank you for getting on the call today. We appreciate you. Have an amazing day.
Absolutely.
Now, next leader, Cece Mahone, you are live.
Good morning, Mr. Berger. This is Cece Mahone calling out of Johns Creek, Georgia. Excellent call this morning. And I just wanted to say that I think that Team Audacity has the most heroes and sheroes, and I'm so proud of each and every one of them. And what the person said this morning on the phone, what we will mean to the world, what Wealth Builders Worldwide will mean to the world, I don't even think we have an idea. Back to you, sir.
I'll say amen to that for sure. And I believe that out of everything that we've been through these years, there's going to be books written about all of us in Wealth Builders. I'm excited because we're making history here. We're changing history. And we're making a mark that cannot be erased. Cece Mahone, we appreciate you and all that you do. Have an amazing day. Let's see if I do that right. Okay. Next leader. What's that? I'm sorry, guys. Hang on a second. My computer's going crazy. Here we go. The King Family Dynasty Radio, you're live.
Good morning, good afternoon. This is Jamal King, aka King Leader 19. What's going on, Burger King? I just wanted to lend my voice to the call. Shout out to all the gold gladiators all over this universe. Please be safe. Shout out to all the leadership. Shout out to the Queen Leader. Shout out to the Princess Leader. Ah, oh,
and you have an amazing day. Always great to hear your voice. Have a blessed day. All right, next leader. There we go. I'm sorry, guys. It takes a little longer to get through the queue than before, so thank you for bearing with me here. All right, next leader, 24 Carat Melody. You're live.
Greetings, Brother Berger. Can you hear me, please?
Yes, yeah.
Excellent. Brother Berger, this is Linda M. and Tim Scott of Killeen, Texas, and thanks for allowing us to lend our voice to the call. Thanks for this morning's batch of nutrition for the mission. We are single-handedly putting the spotlight back on humanity, and the universe, as far as I can see, has literally lined up with our vision and our mission. to the extent that every time we get on the power call platform, hands go up and they stay there.
And they stay there and they go up, down, up, down. Yes, yeah. You have an amazing day. Okay, next leader. I gotta scroll down. Next leader. I'm getting there, guys. It's Danny D. Jane. You're live.
Hello, Mr. Berger. Wonderful call again today, brother. And I just want to lend my voice to the call again and say, love y'all. Peace out.
Great to hear your voice today, man. You have a blessed and amazing day. All right. Oh, there we go. Where'd it go? Okay, there. All right. Next leader, Sharon and Ronald Vix. You're live.
Good morning, Mr. Burka. This is Sharon.
And Ronald Vix.
Calling out of Atlanta, Georgia. Thank you so much for playing that pre-call this morning. And the overview was, of course, fabulous by Miss Yolanda Parkinson. I'm sorry, lost my thought for a second. But I just want to say thank you to all the leaders. All of the leaders in Caribars and Well Builders have become our sheroes and heroes. And my main hero, Mr. Willie Brown, is the reason that we were offered this opportunity. Because as we go through this pandemic or crisis, whatever they want to call it, because of Caribars and Well Builders Worldwide, and because we stay connected daily, we are so at peace with whatever is going on. And it's because we've got God's money and we know we're going to be just fine. Everyone have a golden day. Love you, Mr. Berger. Back to you.
Love you guys back. And you said something powerful there. We have God's money in our hands. We're going to be all right. Ooh. Appreciate you sharing that. You guys have an amazing day. Appreciate you guys so much. Let's see. Next leader, the Gold Man. You are live, brother.
Gold Man. Yeah, that's me. Ashar L out of Daytona Beach, Florida. Just lending my voice to the Carr family. I love the energy. I love when Ty Best and Mike Delco team together and just go back to back. I love it. Hey, Delco, my birthday on the 25th of April. Just remember that. I appreciate it. great team when we will. I love y'all. I'm out.
You have an amazing day. We'll see you soon. Yes, y'all. Next leader, Julie. You're live. You have to unmute yourself, Julie. Okay. Next leader, Dion Steven. You are live.
Good morning, Mr. Berger.
Good morning.
Great. You can hear me. Wonderful. Would like to send out some congratulations to my best friend in Detroit, Michigan. I'm sorry, Dante Taylor. She acquired her bronze package on yesterday. Want to send a great shout out to all of Wealth Builders Worldwide and my WOW sisters. Can't wait to see you all. Have an amazing Friday. Let's go, guys.
And this is a congratulations for that package. Where'd it go? Here we go. Come on now. My audio. There we go. There we go. Wasn't cooperating with me. You have an amazing day, Dion Steven. Whew. Now, next leader. All right. I don't know who. All right. This is, if you are a Samsung owner and your serial number, no, I'm kidding. Samsung SMJ32-7VPPA. We need to get your name on there, guys. You are live.
Okay, I'm going to mute myself. This is Beverly Elliott Butcher in Forest, Virginia, Team Eagle Soar. I had to get on, and I'm glad to be able to get in because this marks 1 year week of my being in Carrot Bars. And my sister-in-law, Simona Elliott, kept after me and relentlessly, but in a kind way, but I couldn't hear her because I had just lost 5 people within 15 months of my immediate family. And I couldn't hear her. So I just want to bring out the point that you all are right when you say that when the teacher, when a student is ready, the teacher will appear. Mm-hmm. The student is not always ready because of some unsurmountable things. But I remember that in the scripture it said 2 fish and 5 loaves of bread. And that's the premise on which I came in on. I saw what the Lord did with that. And I said, I'm going to yield what I have to you in this. Before I can comprehend what's going on, I'm going to yield this to you. Just as watch you do what you did with 2 fish and 5 loaves of bread. Because in the midst of all of this, I had to come out of my house, as many of you all had to do too, through all this struggle and stuff that went on. But now, thank God, I'm praising God for being in Carrot Bars, and I'm learning as I go. Thank you, and God bless.
Thank you so much for sharing that. That's amazing. Whew, I have to, can I give you an applause to that? That's powerful. If I give my applause to work here. All right, come on now. Ooh, Mr. Dalco, can you come on for that? I have to tell you something.
Yeah, that was I was trying my best to restrain myself. That was a great comment.
Yeah,
Miss Elliott Butcher, you know, this industry of network marketing brings that kind of goodness into our lives. I mean, I remember when Dr. Rozelle introduced me to her, I was like, what a dynamic person. But anyway, go ahead, Mr. Berger.
Yes, Mr. Duffa, listen to this. Last night, I heard from a team member. He was the second person who signed up with me or in Care Partners. He's the first person on my right thigh. So you can imagine how many people he got on the right thigh there, right?
Wow.
And he never did anything. He was just a young guy. He didn't know anything. He didn't know better. And then yesterday he reached out to me, Mr. Doctor. He said, I'm seeing what's going on. I think I really need to get some gold. Because I had to give him his account information so he can log in, get his KYC done.
Oh,
so, and here's the power of CareBird, Mr. Delco. You and I both know this. Your account's active. Even if you don't do anything, you can come back 6 years later now, Mr. Delco. He signed up 3 weeks after I registered 6 years ago, and his account's still active. Isn't that powerful? And he has a thousand on his right side.
Let me tell you, Mr. Best said it perfectly last night on the Empower call with Lucian and Coach Mike. Oh my gosh, Coach Mike, if you're on here, thank you, man. Mr. Best said, the fish are jumping in the boat. My second person that I signed up is Judith Cotton. I hope she's on the call. Phenomenal realtor, real estate investor. She has her own brokerage firm, real estate brokerage firm. 45,000 plus people on her team right now. And she's just getting back started. She knows a lot of military people whose 401ks are being devastated, and she's now introducing them on how to get gold in small increments. Another real estate investor, gentleman from my church, Leon Duncan, I hope he's on the call. He probably is. He's been blowing my phone up, getting connected with everything we do. He's got a ton of people. Miss Deion Stevens that you just heard is a part of his team. He doesn't even know her. Because he got started, took action, got a package. This, I'm about to scream, so back to you.
Everybody, just imagine in your head right now, Mr. Dalco running around the house screaming. Ladies and gentlemen, Carrot Bars is incredible, amazing. I am so grateful to be here hosting this call today. Now, William Lynch, you are now live. Mr. William Lynch, you're live. Unmute yourself, sir.
Good morning. Can you hear me?
Oh, I can hear you. How are you?
Good morning. Good morning, Mr. Berger and family. This is the millionaire Jacqueline Smith and Bill Lynch from Chicago. I would like to announce that the team is having a virtual wealth building event this Saturday, March 28th at 3 p.m. We are inviting everyone. The information will be on mywbw.net or my Facebook page. It was an outstanding pre-call and an outstanding overview. Ahoo! Back to you.
I love it. Everybody is taking advantage. They're still having their meeting. I love it, virtually. Man, congratulations to all of you that are still being persistent and consistent. Man, whew. All right, we're going to take one more quick caller here because we are running close to the top of the hour. We've got to get ready for the presenter and get ready for the 12 o'clock presentation. The next leader, Larry Wiggins-Bay, you are live. Unmute yourself, sir. Going one. There you are.
Hey, Mr. Berger, great rise. What's going on, family? Stay with me, Mr. Laughlin. Look.
You're fading in and out, bro. You're fading in and out. We're not hearing you.
Better.
All right, better. You're breaking up really bad, bro.
Oh, well.
Anyway, thank you.
Love you. Safe go.
Yes, sir. We have that part. We heard the last part. Man, have an amazing day. All right, so ladies and gentlemen, we're going to conclude the raising hand session, whatever you want to call it, Q&A. So what we're going to do now, if Mr. Dacko stops screaming, Mr. Dacko, any closing comments from you?
Yeah, it is. You know what? I stopped screaming. I'm hoarse now. I'm trying to clear my throat. But listen. You know, I'm hearing these people doing their virtual meetings. Mr. Bell says it all the time. In the midst of every crisis, there's an equal or greater seed of benefit, right? The crisis brings out opportunity, man. And we're starting to have our virtual meetings instead of our physical meetings. But guess what that means? That means your people that are on your team that are in France or in New Orleans can join your meeting in Philadelphia. Like, it's technologically better than even the live meetings. Now, we're still gonna have our live meetings, boy. As soon as the travel restrictions are lifted, the next Let's Go weekend is gonna be like Coach, like Lucian said last night, 50,000 people in Staples Center or something like that. We're still gonna have our live meetings. But man, the first Let's Go Worldwide Online is on next Saturday. So go right now. Look, just because it's online doesn't mean the seats are unlimited. We pay for those seats. It costs, all right? So it's limited seating still. Go right now to WBWEvents.com. Get your virtual seat for that event. Dr. Harold Seitz is jumping out of his chair. He cannot wait to talk to you guys. Fired up. I've never heard him so excited. I'm thinking to myself, with everything that's going on in the world, he must be really stressed. This man is acting like he's born again. It's like Christmas time. He's so fired up about what he's doing for the world, man. With all the challenges, the champions emerge in times of crisis and challenge. So Dr. Harold Seitz is a champion, and I'm learning from him. Also, the other person I cannot wait to hear from at the Let's Go Weekend, a Let's Go Worldwide Online event, is Ty Best. This man is so jacked right now, man. Y'all just don't know. I mean, I'm privileged and fortunate to have him pick up the phone and call me whenever he feels some kind of way. And man, he's so fired up. I cannot wait until there's a big audience that he can draw from and talk to you guys. He has his two guns loaded, man, ready to do business and share with this whole global community what he has to offer from his 30, 40 some years experience in this industry. So get fired up, guys. We'll see you on the white sandy beaches of the world, or at least the virtual white sandy beaches, all right? Back to you, Mr. Berger.
Thank you so much, Mr. Dacko. Appreciate you, sir. Again, thank you for being my hero. And now for the next group of heroes, the Beth household, Mr. and Mrs. Beth, any closing comments from you guys?
Mr. Berger, great call. I think I've said enough today, man. I really do, and I'm gearing up. I'm really writing some stuff for the nights, the real talk with Mike and Chad tonight at 11 o'clock. So that's it. Ms. Firebest, you want to add anything?
Great call. I'll tell you what, I'm going to see you too, guys, in 2 weeks at the virtual Let's Go.
Next Saturday.
I meant next Saturday. In the virtual Let's go weekend. I'm going to be there.
All right. We are fired up and cranked up. Let's get on 12 o'clock. Mr. Berger, what a great call. Thank you very much, sir. I appreciate that. It's incredible. We'll see you then. Everybody dream big. Yeah, I'm on fire. Talk to you later. Team Best, what do we say?
Ah-oh. Man, love you guys so much. Appreciate you. Thank you for every day being a part of our call. Thank you for being your inspiration that you both are and the whole family. So we love you guys. So, ladies and gentlemen. Oops, sorry, that came up too quick. Ladies and gentlemen, it was my honor to host this call today. Thank you for giving me the privilege to be the host of this power call on Freedom Fridays. I love doing Freedom Fridays. Ladies and gentlemen, go out and do some income-producing activity today. Share that 12 o'clock presentation with everyone right now. It's 12 o'clock on GoldBox, same platform. Might as well stay online with us. Bring all your guests with you. And we're going to close out this Freedom Friday power call with freedom. Let's go. Freedom.
Everything I have, everything I own, all my mistakes, family.